Hi students, have a nice day. In this session we are going to discuss about the density and molar mass of the gaseous substance and some numerical problems. In the last session we discussed about the ideal gas and ideal gas equation. And you remember the values of R depends upon the unit of pressure, volume, number of moles and the temperature. Okay, let's discuss density and molar mass of the gaseous substance. Density and molar mass. As we know that PV is equal to nRT. Ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Also, we know that N is equal to W by M. Weight of the substance divided by molar mass of the substance. Let's equate PV is equal to WRT divided by capital M, molar mass. Okay, another equation. PV is equal to weight of the gaseous substance, universal gas constant, temperature and molar mass. Okay, then we know that density is equal to mass by volume. Density is equal to mass by volume. So P is equal to WRT divided by VM. Another equation. Just rearrange. P is equal to WRT divided by VM. Then P is equal to W by V RT by M. Okay, P is equal to W by V RT by M. Then what is W by V? It is D. So P is equal to D RT by M. Another equation. Okay, P is equal to W divided by V RT by M. Or P is equal to DRT by M. Or we can say that PM, P into molar mass equal to DRT. Okay, PV is equal to NRT. PM is equal to DRT. Or the molar mass of the gaseous substance is equal to DRT divided by P. All these equations are important for numerical calculations. Okay, let's move to the problems. First question. 10 liter of CO2 has to be compressed into an iron cylinder of 1 liter. At constant temperature, if CO2 is at 1 atm pressure, what is the pressure developed in the cylinder? Once again, I read the question. 10 liter of CO2 has to be compressed into an iron cylinder of 1 liter capacity at a constant temperature. If CO2 is at a 1 atm pressure, what will be the pressure developed in the cylinder? Okay, 10 liter CO2 is compressed into 1 liter iron cylinder. Okay, so the volume is changed from 10 liter to 1 liter. So what is V1? Let's collect the data. V1 is equal to 10 liter and is compressed into 1 liter. So V2 is equal to 1 liter. Okay, very simple problem. Next, if CO2 is at a 1 atm pressure, what will be the pressure developed in this cylinder? The pressure of the CO2 is 1 atm. Okay. And the question is, what is the pressure of the CO2 gas in the cylinder? So we have to determine the final pressure. The given data is, at a constant temperature, the gas is compressed. Okay. Compressed into an iron cylinder of 1 liter capacity at a constant temperature. So at constant temperature, pressure and volume relates, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So according to Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. And we have to find P2. So P2 is equal to P1 V1 divided by V2. Okay, P1 V1 divided by V2. Let's substitute the values. P1 is 1 atm. What is the pressure? Initial pressure? 1 atm. What is the initial volume? 10 liters. And V2 is equal to, V2 is equal to 1 liter. And what is the final answer? It is 10 atm. So P2 is equal to the final pressure. The final pressure is P2 is equal to 10 atm. Okay, pressure in terms of atm. 1 atm is equal to 1.01325 barometer. Okay. Then or 1 barometer is equal to 0.987 atm. Also the pressure is expressed in Pascal. Okay. 1.01325 bar is equal to 1.01325 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. Okay. 1 barometer. This is approximately 1. 1.01 is equal to 1. So 1 barometer is equal to 1.0123 into 10 raised to 5. 5 Pascal. The SI unit is Pascal or Newton per meter square. Okay. Then 1 atm is equal to 760 mmHg. All these things you know. 760 mmHg. Or is equal to 760 tau recently. Tau. Okay, you please keep in your mind. 1 atm is equal to 1.01325 barometer. So 1 barometer is equal to, we divide it. 1 barometer is equal to 0.987 atm. Then 1.013 or approximately 1 bar is equal to 1 into 10 raised to 5 or the exact value is 1.012325 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. 1 atm is equal to 760 mmHg or 760 tau recently. Okay, tau. Tau means tau recently. Similarly, volume you know that. Okay, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. I think you know these things. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. 1 liter is equal to 1 dm cube. Okay, I just write it. This is for doing calculation. 1 liter is equal to 1 decimeter cube. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. That's therefore 1 liter is equal to 10 raised to 3. 1000 we can write 10 raised to 3 centimeter cube or cc. Okay, in some problem cc. Cc means centimeter cube. Then 1 meter cube is equal to 10 raised to 3 liters or 1 liter is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. All these conversions you keep it in your minds. It's very important. Okay, 1 liter is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. Are you clear? So pressure, volume. Temperature we know that 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273.15 Kelvin. Or we can take 273. Okay. Yes. Then we move to the second problem. It is taken from the NCERT book 5.1. The question is, a balloon is filled with a hydrogen gas at a room temperature. It will burst if the pressure exceeds 0.2 barometer. If at 1 bar pressure, the gas occupies 2.27 liter volume. Up to what volume can the balloon be expanded? Okay, the second question is taken from the NCERT book 5.1. Problem 1. Exercise, not exercise, workout problem 5.1. Once again, I read the question. A balloon is filled with hydrogen at a room temperature. It will burst if pressure exceeds 0.2 bar. If at 1 bar pressure, the gas occupies 2.27 liter volume. Up to what volume can the balloon be expanded? Okay, a balloon filled with hydrogen gas, H2 gas. The pressure of the gas, that is P1, is equal to 1 barometer pressure. And the volume of the gas, okay, it is H2 gas. Volume of this balloon is 2.27 liters. That is, V1 is equal to 2.27 liters. Are you clear? Yes. And the important thing is, if the pressure is 0.2 barometer, the balloon will burst. That means, P2 is equal to 0.2 bar. When the balloon reaches the pressure, or when the pressure of the gas reaches 0.2 barometer, the balloon will burst. So final pressure P2, and the volume is the question, V2. Up to what volume can the balloon be expanded? Okay. Yes, and temperature must be constant. So P1 is 1 bar, V1 is 2.27 liter, P2 is 0.2 bar, V2 is the question mark. Then according to Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Now we have to determine V2, the volume of the gas. V2 is equal to P1 V1 divided by P2. Okay, rearranging this equation, we need this V2. So V2 is equal to P1 V1 divided by P2. Let's substitute the values. P1 is 1 barometer pressure. P1 initial pressure is 1 barometer. And its volume 2.27 liters. And the final pressure, or the pressure up to the balloon will be expanded. So it is 0.2 barometer. By calculating the values, okay, 2 can be used with 2. So here is 0.1. 1.135. Then 1.135 divided by 0.1 is equal to 11.35 liters. Okay. When the volume of the gas or volume of the balloon reaches 11.35 liters, the balloon will burst. So up to what volume we expanded the balloon? Below that volume. Okay, remember that at 0.2 barometer the balloon will burst. That means the volume expanded, when the volume reaches 11.35 liters, the balloon will burst. So up to what volume we have to expand? Below that volume. Okay, not that point. Since the balloon burst at a 0.2 barometer pressure, The volume of the balloon should be less than 11.35. Okay? Yes. So, that's about the problems based on the Boyle's law. Next, we move to the Charles' law. Okay. The question 5-2 from the NCERT book. On a ship sailing in Pacific Ocean, where the temperature is 23.4 degrees Celsius, a balloon is filled with a 2 liter air. What will be the volume of the balloon when the ship reaches Indian Ocean, where the temperature is 26.1 degrees Celsius? Once again, I read the question. On a ship sailing in Pacific Ocean, where the temperature is 23.4 degrees Celsius, a balloon is filled with 2 liter air. What will be the volume of the balloon when the ship reaches Indian Ocean, where the temperature is 26.1 degrees Celsius? Okay, a ship is sailing from Pacific Ocean to Indian Ocean. A balloon is kept in the ship. The temperature of the Pacific region, so T1 is equal to 23.4 degrees Celsius. And the ship sailing from Pacific Ocean to Indian Ocean, the temperature at that area 26.1 degrees Celsius. And the volume of the balloon, okay, the balloon is filled with a 2 liter air. So V1 is equal to 2 liters. And the ship reaches Indian Ocean, what is the volume of the balloon? That's the question. That means V2 is equal to the question mark. We have to find the final volume when the ship reaches Indian Ocean. Okay, and understand that at a sea level, the pressure must be constant. Okay, here there is no hint about the pressure, but you understand that Pacific Ocean, that means sea level, Indian Ocean, okay, it is also a sea level. So, at sea level, the pressure is 1 atm or 1 barometer pressure. The pressure must be constant in Pacific Ocean as well as in Indian Ocean. Yes, so at a constant pressure, we can apply Charles' law. According to Charles' law, V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Okay. Or one more equation I give. V1 by V2 is equal to T1 by T2. Two equations. We know that. Okay. Two equations. We know. Then, V2 is equal to, what is V2? V2 is equal to, V2 is equal to V1 T2, not T1, V1 T2 brings here, divided by T1. That is equal to, just substitute the values, and remember that we cannot apply the temperature in degree Celsius. You must convert it into Kelvin scale. For Kelvin scale, you just add 273. So 273 plus 4 degree, it is 296.4 Kelvin. Okay, 296.4 Kelvin. 23.4 plus 273, 296.4 Kelvin. Then what about this T2? It is 26.1 plus 273. The correct value is 273.15. You can also use that, but we take 273 is enough. What about this? It is 299.1 Kelvin. Apply it. V1. V1 is 2 liter. Okay, when the ship is at a Pacific region, the volume of the balloon is 2 liter. So 2 liter into T2 is
299.1 Kelvin. And T1 is, not substitute 23, 296.4 Kelvin. By calculating the value, we get, that is 2.018 liters, or it is approximately 2.02 liters.
Okay, a small volume change. Yes, the next question. At 25 degrees Celsius and 760 mm Hg pressure, a gas occupies 600 milliliter volume. What will be its pressure at a height where the temperature is 10 degrees Celsius and volume of the gas is 640 milliliter? Once again, I read the question. It is taken from the NCERT book. At 25 degrees Celsius and 760 mm Hg pressure, a gas occupies 600 milliliter volume. What will be its pressure at a height where the temperature is 10 degrees Celsius and volume of the gas is 640 milliliter? Okay, so let's collect the data. At 25 degrees Celsius, that is T1 is equal to 25 degrees Celsius, that is 298 Kelvin. 25 degrees Celsius plus 273, 298 Kelvin. And 760 mm Hg pressure, that is P1 is equal to 760 mm Hg. And occupies 600 milliliter volume. So V1 is equal to 600 milliliter. What will be its pressure? So P2 is the question mark. P2 is, we have to calculate. P2 is question mark. Then at a height where the temperature is 10 degree. That means the final temperature T2 is 10 degrees Celsius, that is equal to 283 Kelvin. 10 degrees is equal to 283 Kelvin. And the volume of the gas is, 640 milliliter. Okay, 640 milliliter. Then three variables are given. As we know that if we have three variables at a constant number of moles and R, universal gas constant in R, we use combined gas equation. So according to combined gas equation, P1 V1 divided by T1 is equal to P2 V2 divided by T2. Isn't it? Then we have to calculate P2. So what is P2? P2 is equal to V2 brings here, T2 goes there. So P1 V1 T2 divided by T1. Okay. Then V2 comes here, V2. V2 bring here, T2 bring here. So P1 V1 T2 divided by T1 V2 or V2 T1. Yes. Then substitute P2 is equal to P1. What is P1? 760 mm Hg pressure. V1. What is V1? 600 milliliter. T2 is 283 Kelvin. That is T2. This one is T1. Divided by T1. 298 Kelvin. Into volume. Or volume into temperature. Volume is
640 milliliter. Okay, why doing this? Okay, why doing this? The zero can be cut. Then as 76, 64. By dividing with the 4, the value is 4. Divided 4, that is 69. So 19 divided by 16. By doing this, we get the pressure of the gas is 676.64 mmHg. Okay, 676.64 mmHg. Milliliter cancelled, Kelvin cancelled. The final unit is pressure is in millimeter of Hg. Okay, then we move to the next question. Calculate the density of ammonia at 30 degrees Celsius. Okay. Calculate the density of ammonia at 30 degrees Celsius and 5 atm pressure. Density and the molar mass is related. P is equal to dRT by M. Okay. P is equal to dRT by M. P is equal to dRT by M. Okay. So what is D? Density D is equal to PM divided by RT. Density D is equal to PM divided by RT. And the gas is ammonia. Okay. Ammonia is kept at 30 degrees Celsius. So temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. That is 303 Kelvin. And the pressure P is equal to 5 atm. Okay, pressure we have 5 atm. Temperature 303 Kelvin. R is constant. So R is equal to temperature is in Kelvin and pressure is in atm. R is equal to 0.0821 liter atm Kelvin inverse mol inverse. In the last session we learned 4 values for RO. Okay, liter barometer Kelvin inverse mol inverse, liter atmosphere Kelvin inverse mol inverse, joule Kelvin inverse mol inverse, calorie Kelvin inverse mol inverse. The 4 values you should learn. So here the pressure in atm and temperature in Kelvin, volume in liter. So we can use 0.0821. If the pressure is in barometer, 0.0831. Okay, that's the difference. Then molar mass. Ammonia, what is the molar mass? Molar mass 14 plus 3, 17 gram per mol. Okay, molar mass of the gas is equal to 17. Ammonia, the name of the gas is given ammonia, NH3, nitrogen 14, 3 hydrogen, so plus 3, 17. Let's substitute into the equation P, 5 atm. Molar mass 17 gram per mole divided by R 0.0821 liter atm Kelvin inverse mol inverse into temperature 303 Kelvin. Okay, so by computing, by calculating these values, we get 3.37 gram per liter. 3.37 gram per liter. You just calculate it. Okay. By multiplying 17 and 5 and also these two values, final answer is 3.37 gram per liter. The problem is not in the NCERT book. You practice this type of problems. And the last question. Calculate the temperature of 2 moles of a gas occupying a volume of 5 liter at 2.46 barometer. Okay, the question is calculate the temperature of 2 moles of gas occupying a volume of 5 liter at 2.46 barometer. Okay, here the number of moles is given, pressure is given, and also volume is provided. So by collecting the data, number of moles N is equal to 2 mole. And the volume of the gas V is equal to 5 liter. And the pressure is equal to 2.46 barometer. The question is, what temperature? Okay, calculate the temperature. So T is the question mark. By relating these variables, number of moles, volume, pressure and temperature, we know that ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT, where R is a constant. So T is equal to, T is calculated by rearranging the equation, PV divided by nR. Okay, substitute the values. What is the value of R here? Pressure in barometer, volume in liters. So 0.08314 liter barometer Kelvin inverse, mole inverse. Are you clear? Yes. Then substitute. Pressure is 2.46 bar. 2.46 bar. And the volume is 5 liters. The number of moles 2. Okay, 2 mole. You write the unit also. 2 mole into the value of R is 0.08314 liter barometer Kelvin inverse, mole inverse. Okay, and the temperature is 73.97 Kelvin. Okay, very simple problem based on the ideal gas equation. Simple substitution and calculation. So here the temperature of the gas is 73.97 Kelvin. Okay, so that's about the problems based on the gas laws. In the next section, we will discuss about the important concept, Dalton's law of partial pressure. So we will see in the next section with the new concept. Thank you.